This is RJ Radio.
And some of it is so stupid, but I love it.
Only on Live365.com.
The following program is brought to you in living color.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Say what?
Breaking my heart into a million pieces, like you always. Tuesday morning, Roy and Jimmy in the morning here on Live 365. Oh my God, YouTube, Stitcher, iHeartRadio, Podbean, you know what?
Everywhere.
Just look out the window and we'll be there. Ah, good Tuesday morning, everyone. My name is Roy Brewster. This is...
I am Jimmy Shaw. Another edition of Roy and Jimmy in the Morning. This is RJ Radio on a wonderfully sunny but chilly day at the top of the 210 right here in Ranch Cucamonga.
Sunny but nipply.
Sunny but nipply, the way we like it.
Nipply. Did I say nipply? Oh, frickin', that's one of my favorite scenes of all from that movie.
Oh, the Christmas Vacation. Yes.
Yes. Yes.
It's nipply. It's a little nipply.
I said log. I didn't mean log. You don't got... well, me up.
Mary, that's my name.
No shit.
Good morning, everybody. Thanks for joining us again in our brief little video preview right there on the old... what do I want to call that?
Tube of Eunice. I mean, tube of the Facebook.
The facey.
On the facey tweet.
The facey tweets. The birdie face.
The birdie face. Whatever.
The tweet face.
Yeah. Yeah, we had Roy Brewster liked it.
That guy, again, I tell you, he is such a fan.
One comment, one like, seven views. Woo!
We're banging that thing right now.
Killing shit right now. Good thing. You know why?
Why is that?
Because we're available, you could be found anywhere.
I know. Now are we going to get overexposed here, Roy?
Too accessible.
Yeah, it could happen.
Too accessible.
We're too accessible. We're just handy. You need us. We're right there.
We're handy.
We're handy. We're handy people. More handy than attractive.
There, I was ready for
that. That's right. I just gave myself my own setup right there. My own callback, if you will.
I will. You change your clothes before you do it, though. You put on a good working clothes?
Oh, yeah. I've got work clothes.
I got some shit on for that yesterday.
Yeah, you did. I want you in a three-piece doing the lawn. There's our YouTube chat room there. There's my sister. There's my mom. We already got some times going on right there. Let's see. Let me place my bet here at... I'm going to stick with my 709. It's because I was pretty darn close yesterday with that.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Yeah.
I think I'm win.
Oh, God. These sounds...
Say what?
I think I'm going to win.
836.
Mm-hmm. You don't know, but last night I know where Donna lives.
What's that?
I know where Donna lives. I know where Donna lives over there. I know where she lives.
Yeah, I know the area. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, stalking. I'm not gonna say a big hole, but a hole in the middle of tread in the tire, so she could repair it.
Oh, there you go.
It wouldn't cost her any money. She just goes to America Tire. They fix it for free. But
true.
Gonna make her a little late. She's gonna look down and go, "Oh my God, the bottom side's flat." Well, if I go fast, the top side will make up for it.
And if you go fast enough, oh, that's better.
Oh, like that
thing was just blocking my view.
Mm.
There we go.
That's weird. That does that.
It's gone now. Well, this thing was blocking my view from you.
Right.
And now I went, oh, you know what? This thing's adjustable.
Well, now that you did that, now you got to look at me. That's scary shit. I want to know why it buzzes like that. I want to fix it like that. I want to run a little ground wire or something.
Maybe the base
I think I need to ground it. I'm going to ground it. That's what's going to happen.
You do that? You need to get some wires?
A little wire.
A little soldering gun?
A little solder.
Little solder, get that thing all handled for you.
No, I'll probably just wrap it around there four or five times, make it tight. A little electrical tape, just like we used to do our car stereos back in the day.
just tape it up. It's fine. We tape it up. It's fine.
Soldering? No, we don't want to solder it because we're going to replace them in a minute. Uh-oh.
I just like the background thing.
I thought something was coming on. I thought I'm working, was something I should
like I said, I'm working all the angles on this thing just because the thing is such a joy now.
Yeah?
Such a joy. Oh, look at that.
I just want to give you a taste because we're going to come back and do it later.
Let's have it.
But I was thinking, you know, maybe like because it's so early.
Yeah.
Maybe because it's early, we should give them a 210 freeway westbound.
Yeah.
Look at we don't need pretty good slow and go 250 58 miles an hour all the way through. Oh, he even had to put it up in the air already. I was gonna give you a quick one. All the way to Campus Avenue, about 45 miles an hour. Backs up again in the Glendora area.
That's a lot of green.
A lot of green out there today.
That's good.
91 westbound, two left lanes are blocked at where? At Coal Canyon, backed up to La Sierra.
Yeah.
Expect delays up to 1 hour. Phew.
Damn. I mean, that's a lot, but I think that's typical.
Yeah, stop and go traffic up to 1 hour.
I believe that's typical.
So just a little bit. Everything's looking pretty good. Just stay off the 91. 210, leave a couple minutes early. Other than that, you're all right.
Excellent.
I had someone ask me. Said they don't check it in the morning. It cracked me up.
What's that?
I said, well, we don't hear anything in the morning. It's the first thing. I said, well, I'll give you a little quickie. But you got ways.
We're doing this as a courtesy, really.
Is it wonder? What about these traffic copters? Got anything? Because you just pull up the ways, or Google Maps or whatever you want to pull up, it tells you.
And if you go to any other legitimate morning show, they gotta say hi first,
right?
You gotta say hi. There we go. Let's put that bird down. Oh, that's you.
Is that me?
Yes, sir.
I was wondering who that was.
That's you. The subtle back tones of Roy Brewster right there.
Wow, look at Dawn. Didn't have to be at work early, and she's already up.
Well, Whew. Look at that. We're starting to get a full house here.
Wow, there we go.
Well, what do you do?
Well, you know what happens when you bring out the baby elephant walk? People come running.
It's so cheerful. It's so cheerful. It makes people want to move around.
Doesn't it make you want to skip?
It does. It's a skippy song.
You know, I used to skip.
Did you?
But now, right now?
Yeah.
I got to be pretty fucking happy to skip.
I almost skipped third grade. I mean.
Skipped right by that damn
almost thing. Skipped by that bastard, not a problem.
Yeah. It's like that thing when you see a kid running around.
Yeah.
Just losing his shit. I mean, not being bad kid, just being a kid.
Right.
Like running there, and all of a sudden running down. I feel like grabbing him and giving him a little talking to. telling him. You might want to save that.
Give him a little talking to.
Yeah, save that. Because when you get in the 50s, you're not going to want it. And I think what happens, we all have the same energy, about the same energy bank. But we burn that shit out by the time we're about 9.
And you want to blow your knee early on skipping so soon.
Right. So, all those stupid things I did young,
You're
paying for them now. Maybe I shouldn't have been so skippy back then.
And I don't think kids are going to listen. A 5-year-old's going to listen to an old man going, there's your knee joint, there's your spinal cord joints. Yeah, those are the things you need to watch.
Yeah, I'm going to say, shut up, give me some Play-Doh. I don't know what they do now.
Shut up, give me Play-Doh.
I don't know what they do now.
You need to bring that saying back. Just shut up and give me some Play-Doh, goddammit.
Give me some Play-Doh, bitches.
God damn
Listen
it.
Listen here, you old man, smells like, I don't know what.
Oops.
Okay, you got that old man smell.
It's like a musty, manly.
It's not like BO, but it's like maybe there's a crevice. It's not as clean as it should be.
You skip the crevice. That's so gross. Did you get all the crevices? I think that one over here I didn't get. No, I did miss that one right there.
I remember my grandpa Roy. I remember he always had the distinct smell, and it wasn't a bad smell. He didn't stink.
It was just his.
It was just his, and it was kind of. And I never know what he was, but I'm thinking it was probably Old Spice mixed with light cigarette smoke mixed with a little beer.
That's a good smell. You just took me back to my mom and dad's house parties.
Right. And it wasn't, and like I said, it wasn't like, oh my God, what stinks?
It was just that little nice aroma.
It made you feel like you're hanging around a man.
Absolutely.
Right.
Absolutely. Yeah.
And if you got enough, a little bit of that. Old Spice, I think, covers up the crevice you don't wash completely sometimes.
Yeah, it didn't have to be that thorough.
Yeah, you just kind of like, I need a little extra Old Spice, run it down my crack.
Now with the other aromas working it for you.
But no, in my grandpa Frank, he had a certain smell, always. A certain smell. I didn't know what it smelled like. Find out later. It was a shot of Santiago Luz, which was Jim Beam, is what it was.
Oh, Luz on behind the ears? That's some pimp shit right there.
Yeah.
One of those guys, those cool dudes, those Rat Pack guys, they would put like their pinky in the drink, yeah, stir, and then that little splash behind the lobes.
Right.
Yeah. That's good. I like it.
I went to a place that you're going to like. I got to get you there somehow.
Yes.
It's called, this is not a commercial. I wish it was. It's called Son of a Bitch.
I love the name of it. I already love the name of it. I love that name.
Shit.
I think that's that song Lisa Santa. Son of a Bitch.
Son of a Bitch. Detail Garage.
Detail Garage.
Yes. If you're not doing anything one day,
yeah,
I used to take a run down there just to look.
What do we do there?
All it is it's a store.
Oh, the place you told me about.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So if you look at it, this is the inside of it. I mean,
remember how we were all over the wax shop?
Yeah.
All the rubbing compounds and all that.
Oh, I mean, come on.
I'll see my microfiber.
Now the crazy thing is, whoa, what the hell? Oh, 712. That's about right. So, they have, where was I going? Oh, car scents.
Scents. Aromas.
Aromas. Some of the car scents make me laugh.
They make you laugh?
Yeah. They have, I mean the normal, the pina colada, the squash, the, you know, all that shit. And
jasmine, stuff like that.
Yeah, yeah. But you get down a little deep. A little deep. You got grass, fresh cut grass. Oh. Smells like fresh cut grass.
See, I love that smell.
Yes, sir. Look at you.
I love that smell.
Now,
that is a smell of satisfaction.
Right.
Fresh cut grass.
And it smells like fresh cut grass. I mean,
right when you finish that edging, you got that grass smell going on.
And they have
it's fabulous.
The other one, and now these are the ones I don't think I'd want my car to smell like. Okay. They have hot buttered popcorn that smells just like hot buttered popcorn. Okay.
Your car?
Yeah. They have beer. Now, don't you normally put a car freshener in your car to make it not smell like beer?
Right.
Right.
But it smells just like beer. And as we're walking around, they had one of these big jugs. It's like one of these.
Yeah.
And they have their signature scent now, which it's a real good one. I got one. It was black something. But it's about this big. And he told me about it when I was there before. And Dawn went with this time. So we walked around. And she talks about the scents. He goes, what about this one? Yeah. And so he pulls the bit. It's the last one. It's in one of our original bottles. We don't have, this is the last one in existence. So we opened it up and gave her a little smell. And she's like, reenact it. Ooh, that's good. Okay. She goes, man, that smells familiar. I've smelt that before.
Yeah,
and he's like, well, it smells familiar to you? She's like, yeah, it smells like, what's the name? And I already knew what it was a week before. What's the name of it? It's called stripper scent.
Yes, you did smell that. At a baby. That we had that right there.
It was a stripper scent that Dawn said that she, I recognize the smell.
I bet you do.
Right. So he said their new one is called, their signature scent. It's a little less potent, but people got mad. And
just because of the name.
Yeah. And then he said there's another company that does one's called Pimp Juice. And there's another one that doesn't. Yeah, another one. Well, people get all pissed off.
They better not go buy some barbecue sauce.
I think that stripper scent is when you used to. I know this was true a few years ago. It's probably the same when you walk down Hollywood Boulevard. This, besides the smell of urine, the smell coming out of the stores. It's like they all have the same, and I think it's like stripper scent.
Might be.
It's a, it
sets the razz.
It's a weird kind of a. Too sweet.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. poor Blaine. Blaine Humble's in the chat room. He goes, I thought I could see your ugly mugs. I said, no, we can't do that to y'all right now.
You can. Look to the bottom left of the corner. You see us. There's Roy. There's Donna. There's Jimmy. Yeah. And there's the cartoon of our face on top. So get over it, Mr. Humble.
And I'm still advancing this thing. So cameras, he's not the first. We've had requests for the camera setups. Just wait where I got to put a, is it going to be, it's got to be two cameras at least. Maybe a three camera shot.
No, we don't. We don't have to do that.
Right.
Dawn says it's a mixture of men's cologne when she smelled it. So it was actually, it actually smells really good. It's just, it's not too strong, but it has that little, you know what? Maybe it's that old man scent we were talking about. They bottled from back in the day.
Exactly. Yeah.
That way, if you put a little bit in that car and then your crack's not, crevice is not as clean as it should be, it spruces her up a little bit.
You got a little, little scotch behind the ears kind of whiff going on.
It's a crevice sprucing scent is what it is. Okay.
We all could use that.
Yeah.
A crevice sprucing.
Gee, I wonder why they don't market it that way.
You have anything, I don't know, crevice sprucing. I need to feel a little more fresh right there.
Try saying that fast 10 times.
Good morning, Donna Mae.
Like, what's his name? Mike Tyson.
I was going to say.
You and your Mike Tyson.
Crevice boothing.
We are in our Facebook videos. Our buddy Salvador is coming back from the Indianapolis 500. He's on his way home. Big fan right there. Got to see the big race in person there. There's Ariana giving us a wave. Little Robin Aaron, a big fan right there. Thanks, you guys. Always appreciated. And wherever you're listening to or trying to watch here, there's other ways, just in case you have to go somewhere. Go to live365.com, search RJ Radio, youtube.com, search RJ Radio. Mm-hmm. Is that all of it?
Live, yeah.
Yeah, that's live. That's our live options.
Now, when you want to go to the, when you want to go to the dark side.
The dark side,
when you want to listen to us, when you just need to listen to us all damn day long.
You want to go deep. Deep web.
I've always wanted to go deep, just never been able to.
It's just physically impossible. Last time Roy heard balls deep, he tried to play basketball.
Oh my god!
Someone's got some noise going on.
It's not me.
Fun with Roy and Jimmy.
Oh, that's my side.
That's your side. Huh. We're all wondering who Jimmy's looking at me like. Your shit's playing. Yeah. No, it's not.
I'm just
background.
I'm on mute.
Are you? Yeah. Apparently not.
Apparently we have to.
Apparently you
got to
do some
sort of
shit.
Look at that.
What is it? What is it? What are you playing?
I
thought you turned it back up again. I was going to listen some more.
I turned it up and I'm like, well, why is it doing stuff? Because it shan't be.
We were talking about stinky. About
smelling. I know what's going on here.
I know. We were talking about smell. We had a guy at work, a customer at work, was all getting a little crazy. And someone's getting crazy with it. Yeah. And someone's yelling at him. And they're yelling back and forth. I got to go settle it down. And the guy's like, get out of here. You're smoking weed, blah, blah, blah. And the guy just lost his shit. That's what caused it. And he's like, I am not smoking weed. I'm not. I do not smoke weed, blah, blah, blah. And he's going, and they're like almost fighting over if he's not or not. And I'm like, I didn't got to intervene. I pull the guy away. I get him laughing. And we're in the office talking about, hey, man, you know, I'm sorry what's going on. And the guy's like, all right, I probably went off a little bit. I shouldn't have, but it just kind of makes me mad when people like stereotype me and tell me I smoke weed because I don't. And I looked at him. I said, well, I got to be honest with you. You got a little bit of that smell on you. I can smell it.
You have the aroma.
Uh-huh. And he says, I know. Now I'm confused.
Yeah.
So he's complaining that people say he smells like it, but then he's aware.
Not that he smells like it, that he was smoking.
People accuse him of smoking.
Gotcha.
And he smells like it.
Right. And I said, you got that little bit of smell like it. Mm-hmm. And he said, do you know how much this cologne costs? You can buy a cologne that smells like weed. Now, I thought I'm like, oh, no way. He goes, yeah, it's expensive, and I kind of like the smell. It's not real heavy, and it wasn't heavy like someone just torched up in your car and walked out, but there was a little hint of
it,
right?
A hint of it, right. The thing like someone smoked weed in here yesterday.
Right, right. Yeah. Not a lot.
It's very faint.
And sometimes that smell, if it's real light floating in the air, it's not a bad smell. It's kind
if
of
it's light,
right.
Yeah.
If it's heavy, it's over the top.
Yeah. If I barely smell it, then it's kind of like, hey, good for them.
You always used to know, though.
Good for them.
People used to always wear patchouli to cover the scent of pot.
Jesus.
And the patchouli would be so damn strong, you'd know the minute they walked in the room that they been smoking pot and
I don't mind that aroma. The only time I don't like that smell is when it's someone is like, I'm at a party or they're at my house or something, and they come in and that's all they reek of. And you're like, you had to do that right now.
Oh, well, I've you had to do that.
You had to do that 3 seconds before you walked in my fucking door. You know, walk it off a little bit.
Many open mics and many comedy shows.
Oh, no shit.
Where when someone walks in, there's a huge cloud. I mean, there's just a cloud that knocks you over.
That's like saying, that's like being shocked that you smelt it backstage at a concert. Yeah. Yeah, these comics go up this red-eyed and freaking reeking. You're like, go chase your dreams, buddy. This is you're making it happen now.
so here it is. That's cannabis flower. That's not it. But there's we looked it up, and there's actually that smells like you can buy the 420 perfume. Smells like weed.
That's a catchy name.
420.
420.
Catchy.
420 cologne smells like weed. Ba 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 ba. There's just a bunch of different ones.
I wonder what the cannabis flower smells the same way. I don't know.
There's Smoke for the Soul by Killian. There's
Balenciaga.
Demeter Cannabis Flower, Jack by Richard Grant. Fresh Cannabis Santal, S-A-N-T-A-L. But those are all ones that smell like that shit.
Thing is also some pot... is so skunky smelling.
There's some smells. There's some weed smells that are nice. Like I said,
some are better than others.
The faint ones is like I like to give props, going, "Hey, good for you." But when the super strong, it's like, "Oh, goddamn, take it easy." My ex mother in law, very rigid,
very rigid.
Big fun.
Pot smoker.
No, but fun, but rigid. But we go to her place for Thanksgiving, and she had that skin lotion, hemp.
Yeah,
hemp.
Uh-huh. Oh, we got that.
And it has the weed, as the logo, right? And so in her chair, there was like, two recliners, center table. So she have it on the table, but she always turned the weed label around so no one would see it.
Really?
And so me and my brother-in-law.
So she knew what it was.
Yeah. Me and my brother-in-law would always give, as soon as she would get up, we would go over and turn it weed out. And then as soon as she sat down, she'd look. Turn it the other way without saying anything. It's just like, oh my, they think I'm smoking weed. That kind of, move. And so that was like years of her not saying, hey, you guys fucking with my weed lotion?
Turn away the devil flower.
This stuff works great, but I'm not going to tell anyone what it is. And always just turn that label around.
Yeah, Don's got it. It's Hemp's, H-E-M-P-Z.
Yeah.
Yep. It's actually really good.
Hey, Blaine, about that whole rubbing part. We learn from our peers.
Yeah. Come on over here. Let's give you a Blaine sandwich.
We haven't done a good rubbing in a long time, my friend. You got some steaks and some man rubbing going on. And I'll tell you what, that's a boys' night out right there.
I hear there's dinner coming.
I'd love to.
Who's buying?
Shit, I'll buy it if it happens.
Blaine ain't going to meet us anywhere.
Oh, he loves us.
He says he loves us. When's the last time we've seen that guy was at my wedding?
You see, this is what he does. As soon as we get a new listener, he trashes the shit out of him. So Evan calls and Lisa. He just... Our numbers go up. These fuck faces all over.
He does everything he can to scare fuck him
face,
away.
How dare this fuck face tick our numbers up on this morning show? I wanted some privacy, goddammit.
Yeah.
Oh, speaking of, what happened? You said we had how many downloads yesterday?
Oh, shit. I don't know what happened. I announced we're on iHeartRadio now.
Right.
So, among all the other platforms. And we jumped from yesterday morning, Donna, to now over 100 downloads of our podcast.
Just overnight.
Yeah, that was just overnight.
Can't walk the streets in Ranch Cucamonga, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, and we were off the podcast for a while because, the shit got chaotic a little bit there. And all of a sudden it was like... It was like, hey, guys, thanks for everything, but guess what? You don't have this anymore. I was like, well, what do we do about it? And I got, these three brains trying to come up with freaking ideas. And it's like, oh, my God. Oh, my God.
Blaine says nobody knows how to rub me like me.
Those are true facts.
Well, when someone else does it, is that where that saying came from? I wonder. You rub me the wrong way. I mean, come on. This is the way you're supposed to do it.
I think it was Porter, Chris Porter, when on stage he was talking about getting a hand job. He goes, "Ladies, stop it. We know what to do. We got this." I give him a try. I let him do it just because it's like, eh. It's like, It's like knocking on a door, no one answers. It's like, okay, just, you know, knock harder. No, that's not helping.
I can't.
Do I hit the doorbell? No, not really.
I can't continue on the show.
Why?
Blaine said Brewster's a dick.
I told you. Got a new listener Tuesday, and then we got to like beg for everybody on Monday to get that. Well, on that fine note there, let's take our first break here. It is 7:25 right here on RJ Radio. You got Roy and Jimmy in the morning with Donna Main.
Hey.
We are coming back. We got traffic, weather, all the stuff you guys want to talk to. Chat us up on YouTube. Give us a call at
909-509-4063.
We're coming back.
Welcome back to Roy and Jimmy in the Morning here on Live 365 and YouTube. Chat room's blowing up. Everyone calling Roy a dick. I'm not happy about it.
Too close to home? So. Well, I mean, you're busy, but man, apparently your pants are busy.
Yeah.
Do we
have some music for that?
I don't.
The mystery of Roy's
pants. Yes, I do. It's
definitely Tom Jones right here. I feel it already. I can feel it in my bones.
Are you feeling what?
I feel it in my bones.
Oh, you're feeling that. Let me see if I've got that.
Oh, what? My pants came back, cleaners. Mm-hmm. Cleaners. Mm-hmm. Good stuff for work.
And they're nice pants. Yeah. You're a goddamn professional.
Right. So, well, you know, cleaners.
Yeah, these are business formal.
Exactly.
Yeah. Pants.
I'm a little concerned. Now, first off, if I take it to my cleaners by 10, they're back by 4. So this is one thing. That's something you need to understand. But I reached my hand in my pocket right now. I hadn't worn these pants yet. I pull out one of those 3M sticky things you put on the wall.
Right.
And then you put it on the wall, and then if you want to remove it, you just pull down on the tab.
Yeah, when you want to hang a...
It's a little mini hook.
Right.
Yeah.
You want to hang a picture.
A sticky hook.
A little hooky.
Christmas decorations, that kind of thing.
Sticky hook.
I have that. Also in the same pocket, this is scary. Don, tell me if we went somewhere I don't remember, because I'm pretty old. You know, kind of like, do I like this? I have a Disney Parks authentic original tag that looks like it was on something. It was, whatever it was extra large.
Somebody bought at either the Disney store or at Disneyland or downtown Disney.
Yeah, no.
Yeah.
So it's extra large, so we know it wasn't mine. Wasn't extra large.
We can break the clues down here. Right. Okay, so it's an extra large.
Right.
Rory does not wear anything extra large. Except the condom. I didn't say it fit. I'm just saying. Yeah.
Like dropping an orange in a frickin' paper sack.
That's when I hear that thump at the bottom.
I'd be happy to get bottom. Distributed by... Oh, I got to put my glasses on to read this.
Gets a little tiny there.
Yeah. It says distributed by Disney Theme Park Merchandise, Lake Buena Vista, Florida, 32830. At Disney. Now, on the other side, it does say extra large.
Right.
The SKU number is 400204195-9.
Wait, we're looking it up. I'm going to look that up. Huh. Let's find out what garment this is from here.
See what it is.
Okay. Yeah. Now, the price was $24.99, which is bullshit because nothing at Disney is $24.99.
All right, give me that SKU again.
Hey, good morning, Dan.
Must be an extra large lollipop.
SKU number is $24.99/9.
Jesus, that's a hell of a fucking phone number right there.
So maybe you put that in Disney, or I don't know. I have a QR reader. I don't know. Maybe we scan it.
Let's just see what we got here. I'm just throwing in all the simplicity of it.
Right. So
skew.
This is in my pocket as well. So I want to know what's at the cleaners. Who's wearing my pants?
Someone. Someone stole your pants.
I did not go to Disneyland.
And who would wear such dressy pants to Disneyland? That's another thing.
Right. Probably a big Asian guy, maybe.
You got your little sticky hook.
make a lot of picture for Mr. Loy Creek Creek.
Is that it right there? Right?
You're pretty sure that's what happened.
Did you find it?
I'm hunting it down right now, but I did find a place to find it at.
And a little sticky hook that has not been used yet.
No, it's been used. It's kind of.
Is it?
Yeah, I'm pretty sure it's been used.
The plastic thing is still on there.
Well, yeah, but see, you put this on the wall, and then you put this on, and then you pull it. So these are replaceable. This goes on the wall first. So I broke it now. But I want to know who's wearing my pants. Yeah, Ernie's asking, sure wasn't spelled Disney and not Disney? No, I'm looking at it right now. It says, welcome. It says Disney Parks, D-I-S-N-E-Y Parks, Authentic Originals. So I don't know. If anyone's working at Disney, you know.
Take off Roy's pants.
No, I'm going to send you a picture of this. I want you to scan it. Tell me, number one, if someone got a deal. Number two, what it is.
Yeah.
And
there's no specific one coming up, but there was a variety of what it could be. We have a Winnie the Pooh 9-inch rattle, a Minnie Mouse series aerial plush, Millennial Falcon pin.
What would be extra large, though?
Right.
That doesn't make sense.
Maybe the rattle, that 9-inch, is extra large, if you know what I'm saying.
Well, it's a little 9-inch.
Maybe a different Disney store.
Maybe it was the one, like Ernie said, it was the Disney. Like Disney.
Exactly.
Hey, you want to take a look at Disney? I got Disney right here.
Look at that. Hey, Big Ern, how you doing, buddy?
Hop on this e-ticket,
dude,
ride.
I know you saw my comment, but you did that chili video again, and I'll tell you what, man, that warms me up. I love that. I love that. Remember the chili video we played for you where our buddy Ernie, he homemade chili going on, and he put Careless Whisper, the saxophone, to that? It was freaking just awesome. Yeah, Roy can pull that up there.
Okay. Yeah.
And this guy, David Morrow. Good morning, buddy. Mm-hmm. We have a full house going on, you guys.
Wow.
You know what we should do? And it's just, you know, top of my head.
What should we do?
Top of my head. Just.
Now I pull up that Disney thing.
Yeah.
And it comes up these.
What is that?
Little girl.
Little girls.
Wait a minute. Little, what is it, like a, but you,
right there,
a dress,
Disney X Pippa and Julie,
a little dress for $25.
So
I don't know.
So,
somebody's too cheap for Disney.
So somebody's baby daddy borrowed your pants while they're at the cleaners.
Who's
maybe
your,
someone
who's your
had
daddy?
A, maybe someone had a little
brings a little, whole new meaning.
Maybe someone had a little fantasy and a little Disney.
So
they're saying.
So the mama said you're gonna pick up your daughter. Aww. And you're going to look goddamn decent. And he panicked, went to the dry cleaners.
Yeah, I can't be. These are $44.
No, the clothing is way too expensive. That doesn't work.
When you said the mama said,
the mama,
you know what you reminded me of?
The mama said.
It was at least sound like Lionel Richie.
All night long.
Yeah. Yeah, attaboy.
Look at you. That's a good callback, right? Yeah. You did well.
Well, hey, thanks.
You did.
Hey,
well.
Good morning, Ernie.
I don't know. Do they have extra large Mickey ears or Minnie Mouse ears?
I don't think so.
Well, we have a Disney mystery going on. All right, Donna, let's get everybody caught up here on our fantastic weather update.
All right, guys. Little Sticky Hook. That's my rap name. Little Sticky Hook. I like it. Hi, guys. Good morning. This is Tuesday already, right? The 28th. All right, guys. It's like, 3 weeks to summer? We finally have this beautiful sunny day today, Rancho Cucamonga. It is currently 54 degrees and sunny. And the high today is going to get up to 76 degrees.
Nice.
Y'all, as the kids say. Y'all. Everybody talks like they're from the South now. Everybody puts y'all on everything. When did that happen? San Francisco.
Y'all ready for this?
Yeah. 56 degrees right now, partly cloudy. And in the Bay Area, the city by the Bay, it'll be 65 degrees is the high today. Sedona, Arizona, 52 degrees right now and sunny. the high will be a lovely 71. So that's weird. It's getting warmer here and it got like a little cooler there or something. Anyway.
For Donna.
I'm just talking to myself. Hi, guys.
You got me turned down. Sorry. I got this for Donna.
Okay. There we go. Now I feel like I'm at a Laker game.
Y'all ready for this?
We're kicking up the weather report thing.
All right. And let's go to Corpus Christi, Texas.
2-hour show, Donna. Let's go.
84 degrees. This is for Kimberly. We'll just ignore these guys right now, Kimberly. 84 degrees right now, mostly cloudy and windy in Corpus Christi. But the high today will be 90 degrees. So perhaps a little humidity, but they have a breeze going on. So maybe not so bad.
But it's a dry breeze. A Drew Brees?
The Drew Brees?
Is that a Drew Brees?
It's a Febreze. I don't know. Anyway, that's it. That's it. I'll leave it at that. Did you want another one?
No.
He told me it's a 2-hour show. So.
No, I don't.
Right, no, we don't.
So rude.
You're so rude,
right? Calling me rude in the chat room, telling me I was rude because I said good morning to everybody, and then I saw that your mom, the beautiful Paulette, had said, "Good morning, my Donna," and I thought, "Oh, that's so sweet." I said, "Good morning, Mom Paulette," and then Roy.
Well, if you read the room. Yesterday, Roy had a T-shirt on, and he wasn't so stern with us. Mm. But here he's got the business attire, the sharp collar, and all that, and it's a little business, a little power.
A little clenching the butt a little more.
You've heard of a power tie. Yeah. Call this the power collar.
Yeah.
Right there. So let's...
He's a little more, he's sitting up a little straighter in his chair.
A little prouder.
Starfish a little tighter.
All right, let's throw Roy up in the air.
That would hurt.
It's going to take like.
I don't think we're
going to have the team lift that.
I don't think
Donna.
I'm going to help you much with
that. All right, what's the copter we have up today, Mike?
We are the Roy and Jim in the morning.
Little sticky hook.
Humbles. Humbles copter.
The humble copter.
The humble copter.
We got to get that wrap.
The humble copter for, our buddy. Maybe tomorrow could be Ernie, but the big Ern copter, but no. It's the humble copter today. We are up in the air. Looking around, see what we got going on. I just lost my traffic thing. 91 freeway westbound at accident moved to the right shoulder at Cold Canyon Road. Backed up. Oh, expect delays up to an hour. Looks like it's backed up all the way into Riverside. 210 freeway westbound. Wreck in the center divider. Uh-oh. At Carnelian.
Uh-oh.
Right here. Look out. See if we see it.
That's over there.
Reported. Okay.
Look out the window.
Reported 19 minutes ago.
There's not much red, though, on the map. You know?
Did I talk during your frickin' weather report?
Donna.
Why, yes, you did.
I just said 2-hour show, and we're over. Now you're busting into my shit because you got enough time in your own goddamn weather. Now you want to get on a traffic board, too? I'm going to throw you out of fucking helicopter.
Oh man.
Kids.
Jesus Christ.
Kids.
Crash block in the right lane, 10 freeway at the 215, backed up to Rancho
Dad,
Avenue.
Dad, tell him to stop.
Shut the fuck up. Do you ever. Jesus Christ.
He's doing it again.
405 north at the 101, reported 739. Crash block in the left lane. Let's go way up high. Accident moved out of the lanes. 210 freeway at La Tuna Canyon Road, backed up La Crescenta Avenue.
La Tuna.
Only 10 minutes. Still fucking talking. 257 freeway is actually all opened up. No problem there. And a slight backup, Euclid Avenue 71 down to the 91. Not as bad as normally. Speeds are down to like only 20 miles an hour. Usually down to 10. And that's your first Humble Copter update for Roy and Jimmy in the morning.
Humble Copter. I do like how that sounds. That is a wonderful sound right there. This traffic report brought to you by Weed Spray and Disney Princess Attire.
Weed Spray? Where'd that come from? Weed Spray. Sorry.
The cologne.
You know what I was thinking?
Huh?
Roundup. I was thinking Weed Spray.
Roundup. You know what I was thinking, Roundup. Let's see. So Roy drops his pants off.
Yeah.
without...
We can't find... If anyone has a way to look up this barcode...
Right. We need a barcode looker-upper.
We need a scanner.
We need a barcode. Now, is there
take
actually...
Take it to Target and scan it.
I was going to say... I'm sure there's an app. I'm sure there's an app where we can download for that.
I'm looking. Because this is really weird. If I could find what it was, at least.
Here we go with Ernie Avila with the weather update. Charleston, South Carolina, it's 93 degrees. Holy shit. God damn, that's...
Well, they've been having some bad storms in the Midwest.
Damn, that was a good one right there. But there's your live update there. So yeah, we're looking for a skew, everybody. So definitely help us out with that. And we need to find out who took Roy's pants.
Mm. Well, there's a barcode scanner pro here. I'm going to download it.
Yeah, let's do it. We need to find this out.
I'm going to find out what it... You know what's going to be weird? We find out what it... Because Dawn said something. She said... she can't remember what was happening, but she asked, maybe I bought something for one of the grandbabies for their birthday or Christmas. Right. I didn't have these pants at Christmas. Mm-hmm. So now it even gets deeper. And I just got back from the cleaners.
Did you turn on Skype? We missed a call.
Oh, son of a bitch.
Hey, look at my phone's blasted up here. Missed call. I'm like, oh, man.
Hey, if you called, give us 2 seconds.
But did you have the pants then?
No.
Okay.
I didn't have the pants then. So if someone stole the, if someone wore these pants, we're at the cleaners and went and do some shopping. Maybe they didn't. Remember Sean talking about the DNA? Maybe DNA was in the pants, so they sprinkled them off wherever they stole this shit
right
from.
Yeah.
Cops are going to be coming to my freaking door thinking I stole a Disney princess bullshit. And it's not my fault.
Busting the door down.
Probably robbed a bank in your pants, Roy.
Did you rob a bank in those pants, stud? Yeah, maybe. Maybe I did. Maybe I didn't. And there we are.
Funny how that works. Well, that's because your phone's ringing, too.
Oh, gotcha.
Line one, you're on the air.
So you don't pick up the phone anymore?
Oh, Jesus, criminy. Well, I didn't log into damn Skype because I'm on a damn mystery trying to find out who's wearing my pants.
His pants are busier.
You got a big problem, right?
I know. Who's wearing my pants?
His pants have a life of their own, but he's heard that before.
I thought, oh, there's something wrong. They're not picking up the phone. And then so I went back to listen. And you went, oh, my God, missed call. See? I know.
It's a busy show this morning.
Yeah.
It's like firing up the space shuttle. You got to click, 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 all these knobs and buttons and doodahs and widget calls and Blaine Humble stuff.
Blaine screwed it up.
It was Blaine that did it. It was him logging on to YouTube that threw you guys out in left field somewhere.
And as we get a new listener, we're more stunned than happy.
More stunned than you were when your dad talked to you yesterday morning?
No, that might be the ultimate right there. That might be the ultimate stunnage.
Hello. Morning to you.
Hey, good morning.
Hey, Dad, what are you doing?
Just leave it at morning.
There you go. That's two in a row. I mean, they're really busting your balls up there.
Yeah, really.
If anybody knows anything, my dad is not a morning person. So this is two in a row. Don't kill my dad. Come on, man.
Yeah. Well, that's okay. We're going home. Home today.
Bring it home.
We'll get back on schedule, but your dad's not up at 6 o'clock in the morning anymore.
I know. Yeah, no, don't do that to him, poor guy. Yeah. Poor guy.
I get it.
Give the man a break.
I give you a weather report from Arizona, from Topak, Arizona. Oh. It is currently 66 degrees.
3 degrees
sunny,
perfect.
With a high expected to be around 90 today.
All right, summer's coming.
Sounds like a good time to come home.
Yeah. We'll be near 90 by the weekend here. So, yeah.
What's the name of the town?
Topak.
Topak.
Yeah, it's right there at the the 40 and the river right there. Arizona. Okay.
So, like, how far would that be from Phoenix or
it's about an hour and a half from Phoenix. Mm-hmm. We're out by when you come out the 40 and you just cross over the Arizona-California border, it's the very first exit there. It's about maybe 10 miles, maybe 15 maximum from Needles.
There you go. Okay. The generalized area right there.
Yeah,
If you're heading to Laughlin, skip over an exit and you're all set.
I see.
Yeah.
Excellent.
So, we just thought we'd give you guys an update on the weather and say good morning and let you get back to whatever it is you guys do in the morning.
We're still trying to figure that out.
Yeah, that's all right. That's okay.
All right. Safe trip back. Let me know when you get home.
I shall. Okay.
Bye
bye.
Yeah. Bye. Thanks for calling in.
Look at that. That damn thing works.
Right. So, David popped in the chat room. Said he took my pants.
Oh, really?
Okay. And he's going to use them for kindling for his barbecue when he kicks my ass.
Throw them in the microwave, David.
You know what? You could both go to hell.
Well, you know, we have a room full of barbecue action going on here because we set this thing up. There's not only you and David, but we also have Big Earn. Yeah. Blaine Humbles.
Blaine's a cure.
And we get Sean Williams up in that thing. Because I remember him and Dan having that barbecue little debate going on.
That was so funny. The night they had that debate,
yeah,
Dan melted down his computer.
Yeah.
They were fighting on the radio show. We did a show before where he was in New York and we were out here. We had Sean on the phone. Mm-hmm. And Sean was talking so much shit. Dan got pissed off and all of a sudden the show went off the air because we didn't know what happened. It went through his computer. He knocked over his freaking drink on his laptop and melted it. Show over.
So just imagine Roy and his buddy David, the way they go after each other.
Right.
Dan actually taking it so personal that he flung his arm from the other side of the country.
Yeah.
And blew out his computer because Sean gave him enough shit. Yeah, I'm happy to say that will not happen here, but I'm just saying we have this room here with, like I said, Big Earn, we've got David, Blaine, me, Roy. Oh, man, the plethora of queuing going on.
And we can take the cool new board you have and do a live broadcast, or maybe just do it offline and put up as a podcast later.
Exactly, we can do it either way. So we can go live broadcast with this, we can podcast it. It's all the makings.
It's going to be big.
Of a summer blowout, especially with summer coming here. That the season's ripe.
I think
we need to do some location shows.
That's
what
I'm
saying.
We need
to go Absolutely. And do the barbecue thing outside. And
we should try it out. We got to slowly try it out, like at a Starbucks where we got the internet connection. Just, grab our Mocha Locos and fucking set up.
You know, I want to see if we can. And this is
the cornhole tournament.
A cornhole game. It's summer. We have to do this. Cornhole, barbecue.
They have cornhole at a lot of the breweries.
They do.
So, yeah.
What do you got?
Be outdoors doing that stuff. That'd be fun.
Go.
Yes.
Your turn.
No, I don't want to now.
Then don't.
Then I gotta know.
Then I'm not gonna now. We have, though, speaking of the phone, the phone working and stuff, we've got something going on. I had to heed the mic over. We got something coming up on Monday.
Oh, we do.
We do, yeah.
Yes, we do. I was like, we do.
We do.
We're going to talk to Canyon Fessler, young lady from Pennsylvania. She's modeling, and she's been in a movie, and she's actually just released. She's going to be in another one that we talked one yesterday, and she's going to be in another one. The following that, and this is the one she's in right now, is from Gravestone Films. That's the one she's in. Mm. But there's another one coming out that was just released that I can't find a thing on now. So she's going to be on the phone with us 8 o'clock hour Monday.
So what's her name?
Canyon Fessler.
Canyon Fessler, an actress, and she reached out to us, and we said absolutely. So she'll be calling in at the 8 o'clock hour on Monday on the show, and we're in Jimmy in the Morning.
Yeah.
So now that this thing is stabilized and we can take some, let's get some guests calling up in this bitch.
Yeah, you're going to have to listen to YouTube, only one call at a time.
Oh, yeah, I didn't.
I thought you meant when she was on.
A guest call so we can interview her. I don't want to talk to anyone in the chat room. Come on. We are chatting.
I'm a center thing. Announcing your visit. So,
stay tuned for that. So, like I said, 8 o'clock hour, we'll have her up in there. And it'd be fun to talk to somebody who doesn't know us.
Yeah.
Yeah, maybe they won't think I'm a dick.
They won't think you're a dick or something, you know? Very important.
Well, people like, oh, I know Roy. I can call him a dick. Well, you know what? You can't. Come on over here. Take some shit. Let's go. I'm going to knock you down with my freaking hooky thing. I got my pants that I know where it goes to. And I'm going to hit you. I'm a paper cut you with this extra large tag.
Such a goofball. Look at that. It is 8:02 right here on Roy and Jimmy in the Morning. It's RJ Radio with Donna Main. Give us a call at 909-509-4063. Celebrity birthdays, couple lists. Who knows?
A few things coming up.
It's coming.
I nailed that part.
You crushed it, buddy. You crushed it. You got Roy and Jimmy in the Morning right here, RJ Radio with Donna Main. It is 8:11.
Oh, my God. Already?
Already. Boy, your eyes bulged out. What'd you see?
A giant blue whale surfaces next to a paddleboard. Look at that. Big old whale, and you're on a paddleboard out there.
When was that?
That is... That's incredible.
That was
the whales are, they're so friendly. They don't bug anybody if you're on their board or their paddle like that.
That was Newport, right? Yeah. Newport Beach.
Yeah, they just pop on there and they're like, hey, how's it going? How's it going, guys?
Yeah.
Hey,
yeah,
whale.
What's new?
Hey,
what's
whale.
What's up, you big bitch?
Is that whale's name Sally?
Yeah.
Hey, Sally.
What's up?
What's up, Sally?
Sally.
Sally, you know, that girl.
I can't find what I was looking for now. I saved something.
Who's Sally? I don't know what you're talking about.
I was looking for something else.
Roy's bet there, right there.
Oh, that I forgot I was going to look at.
All right, let's do it. While you're hunting down, we'll do a quick little celebrity birthdays with Donna Main right here.
Oh, the birthday, son of a bitch.
All right, get ready, Roy. Get ready. Gone.
I got to have, there'll be math here.
Yes. There might be math, yes.
There will be math. Oh, there's my music. Okay, I'm going to dance around while I'm doing this. What was that?
Go ahead.
Oh,
celebrity
okay.
birthdays.
Celebrity birthdays. May 28th.
Not me, man. Oh, maybe it is.
All right, we only have a couple. We only have a couple, Roy, and they're both musical people.
Fine.
It's good to see your excitement and enthusiasm. Singer John Fogerty. It's his birthday today. He sounds like he came from the bayou, but he's actually a California dude. Yeah.
Mr. Fogerty.
So, Mr. Fogerty. CCR.
I thought you'd pull some center field. That's in center field. It's baseball season. I'm just giving you shit.
Oh, my God.
Now we feel bad.
What? Shut up. Okay, so Fogerty, he'd been around a long time.
Yes.
So I'm going to say, I'm trying to think when, now this is actually not early. I'm thinking I got to go back earlier CCR and where I was then. So, I'm thinking John was probably, I'm going to hang a 20, we're going to go 20 to 25 on John. Now we have to do is get it pulled down here. 25, if we hung a 25 on John, that would mean 50, 54, 64, 7, 79. Now, I don't think John's almost 80.
I know he has a couple of sons that are also musicians. But
I don't think John's. And I think John would be, I'm thinking John's right around my dad's age. But I'm thinking he might be just a little bit more of the geese. Let's hang a 25. No, 20. Let's hang a 22 on John. The 22 would be 54, 64, 74, 76. That sounds too old. But 75, 70, 73, 74, 75, 76, 70. Right, 75.
You should see the
75,
smoke 70, coming 70, out of
75,
his ears. 75. Ooh, so close.
Damn it.
So close.
What do we got?
Damn it.
He's 74 today.
Ah.
Yeah.
That damn Roy, that's...
Missed
that
it by one.
So close.
Damn
that's
it.
That's not bad, Roy.
That sucks.
That
yeah,
bad.
But better than yesterday. Yesterday I was off.
Yeah.
I was off on average by like six yesterday.
Yeah, yeah five, the, six, yeah.
But those were people that we were not as familiar with. Okay.
A, still a good job. Okay, next
All
one.
All right, next one. Another biggie. Singer Gladys Knight. It's her birthday today. He's come to know. Gladys Knight. He said he's going. He said yeah. he's
going, going back to find.
That.
Going back to find. Ooh, 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 ooh. Oh, come on.
And she's still, I think Ray, she's I think still Ray, good. I mean, she's still... cooking. She's I think, still doing it.
I think Roy's going to take his time just so we can hear the music a little more.
Yeah. I think she was on the... We was it her on that was... It was I think it was her that was on... Yeah, but she was on...
Mass Singer.
Mass Singer.
You're right.
So beautiful. So she's amazing.
Still, yeah, she still sounds amazing. Great. She still sounds great. I think she did like the New Year's Rockin' Eve or something too. Some stuff like
Super
that.
Super Bowl. Anyway, or no.
Or, like, she's done some major things lately.
National Anthem. Super Bowl.
Oh, okay. That's what it was.
What a fun, classy lady. Okay, here we go. Let's get back to
yeah.
it. I'm thinking Gladys is...
we got to work on our choreography.
I think Gladys is right around Fogarty age.
I think that's fair.
Kind of same era.
Same era, 60s, yeah.
Yeah.
And Fogarty was 74?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And I said he was 75, so we're going to lock into a 75. 75.
Ooh, you are exactly right.
Oh!
Nice.
Ooh, I thought I was off.
Yeah, look at her. She did a little tease on that right there. Excellent, Roy. Good job,
Gladys
buddy.
Gladys Knight is 75 years old today.
And still beautiful and still amazing
still
and talented.
Great.
And
great. Yes. Yeah.
Good
yeah.
job, buddy. Good job, Roy.
I had to redeem from
So
yesterday.
You missed, there was only two. Missed one by yeah. a 1 year.
So I'm a half.
And the then nailed one. It. So that is, yeah. that is what, 99.9% accuracy right there.
That's,
boom, 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 yeah. boom.
That's amazing.
We give you a J.D. Powers rating, you would be right, 99%. 99.999% customer satisfaction on that, Roy.
And we have one movie released on this day in 2008. Sex and the City.
Sex the and movie. The City, the movie.
The movie.
I've seen that so many times, and not yeah. by choice.
Was it good?
Lots
it's actually
of,
decent, yeah. The movie?
Of, mm-hmm. Oh, okay.
Yeah, the first one's good. The second one's just, you know, they had to churn one out.
Yeah.
You can tell.
I know my daughter used to watch the TV show back in the day, and then the movie. I know we had the movie on DVD. I don't think I ever watched the whole thing all the way through.
Well, that's not fair.
But... lots of inane stuff about, you know, shoes and having sex with lots of people.
That was pretty much about a lot of sex and sex in the city yeah. and then city in the sex.
Shoes yeah. and banging.
Bang
that's
shoes.
Right. Banging shoes.
Bang shoes.
You know.
See, shoe bang.
Here.
Shoe bang.
You
bang.
Luke Bryan's new song. Have you heard it?
No.
It's Knockin' Boots is the name of the song.
Oh, Jesus. I thought it was... Shoe bang.
Pandering to your audience.
And
holy
it says,
shit.
One part says, and boots need knocking boots. I crack up. I'm like, what?
Yeah,
did you just call a song knocking boots?
Some knocking flagrant boots. Pandering to your audience
but
there.
But then these boots are also made
them
for walking.
Them red so solo cups
They're made
up.
For walking and knocking. Yeah, I those, guess that's.
Those red solo cups went up and them boys said, yeehaw, get her done.
Hey, we'll just give you a little taste.
Get her done.
Let's give it a little taste.
Course,
all right, give it a little, let's give it a taste of this.
Uh-huh. See there? See, ads aren't too smart for us. We're getting pretty sharp.
You got
this
down, buddy. Fuck
all right,
ads.
Let's see.
Truck needs a half tank.
These wheels need a two-lane. This radio needs three songs to play to get me across town to you. That dress needs to slip off.
See? Ooh.
That hair needs to come down.
Ooh.
Oh my goodness.
Friday nights need to do what Friday nights need to do. That's the truth. Yeah, birds need bees and ice needs whiskey. Boys like me need girls like you to kiss me. Fishing in the dark needs nitty gritty. Under that pale moon, sweet tea needs that sugar stirring. Small town nights need both ends burning. Shades need drawing. Hearts need falling.
Here we go.
Boots need knocking. Knocking boots.
Can he throw any more stereotypical bullshit in this song?
Well, now here's the thing. See, now you're now the thing that cracks me up, because a lot of people don't like the new country, whatever they call it, which kind of cracks me up, because if you used to love the Eagles, you should kind of like new country, because it's kind of the same. But now, no, if you listen to it, it's the same type of beat
they don't
and stuff.
Have the twangy voice going on, like, you know,
a lot of it
everything
does.
To me,
that
all
twangy.
That twangy stuff sounds the same.
But this, no, that's the thing. Sorry. It's not twangy. This is where I'm going to this one. Now,
well, his,
this
the
people
way he
say
sings it though. It
I is. Didn't finish my friggin' thought. Jesus Christ. Okay, so now this song, it, like new country, no one likes new country, but it's like if it was kind of like you should kind of like Eagles type stuff,
right,
like
right.
kind of. But if you go to this song, people say, "Let's go back to country, old school country."
Oh yeah.
Now, if you think of old school country, it's kind of what he's doing. He's singing about that old freaking bullshit
okay,
country stuff.
I gave it a little shit, but I see what you're saying. Yeah, right. This is country music is boys and the
right.
pickup trucks and they're drinking, and that's pretty much the genre on that there. And everything goes in a cycle. Okay.
In a weird way, this is kind of throwbacking.
A little bit, yeah. Okay, I can agree with you there. Yeah, because everything goes through a cycle. You know, the love songs get to be a little, and then the rock and roll gets a little, and then it all kind of comes back around, gets your spark. That, to me, is typical country right there. Absolutely.
So, because
so
if you...
it's either, like, really, really sad stuff, like, you know, my dog died, my wife left me.
Yeah, that's kind of what he's saying.
And then, exactly. But then this one is...
Boots couldn't boogie.
This is like the horny country dude.
See,
because if you look at, if you think about, and they're one, they're a big group, and very popular, and I love his voice, but we're gonna got it, and this is so mainstream now, but this is country, and this is where people say bullshit.
I like the Cars.
Oh, this is a new one. New
well,
country.
Well, no, it's not. This isn't that new. This is 10 years ago.
Oh,
but same type.
Right. The how you're coming around.
How you're now people saying I hate this because this is not country. And I can see what they're saying. This is more kind of like mainstream, but this is the come on, let's go. Come
this
on.
Is from they had this in
there
Cars, the animated movie.
Yeah, that's actually Rascal Flatts.
Oh wow.
So they call that country.
Yeah.
Now to me, I don't know.
Now here's the deal. To me, if it wasn't for his voice, it's not really country. He actually sells it with the singing right there.
It's the voice,
A little toe tapper right there.
It's a fun song. It's fun, especially for the movie.
It's funny enough, I like this version better than I like the original.
Well, this was the original.
Tom Cochran.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
I get what you're saying.
Yeah, they made it fun sounding, but like I said, the only part of that's country is his voice. And then it brings it right into the twang.
Right?
Yeah.
So,
brings it right to the twang.
So now people give... It's like Brad Paisley saying about checking for ticks.
Yes,
remember that
that's
one?
Right, yeah. That's right.
I want to check you. What was it? I want to check you
that's
for ticks.
That's pretty subtle. Pretty subtle.
I want to take you behind the bushes and check you for ticks. What? What?
That's some romantic shit right there.
I was
going to
say, we got to write down these pickup lines. I want to take you out back and check you for ticks, baby.
Yeah.
Well, Kylie said something to Don one time, because we listen to country most of the time.
Uh-huh.
And she said... Every country song has to do with alcohol. And we're like, no, it doesn't. Yes, it does.
Oh, shit.
Yeah. Yes, it does. If you're drinking a beer, you're drinking a whiskey, you're drinking something else, you're drunk.
And that's what makes it country.
Wow.
Yeah, you're getting drunk or you were drunk and you did something stupid. Or,
right.
Yeah, yeah.
And then on the same lines is if you go into the 70s rock and roll is basically drinking and women.
Yep.
You know, the old Aerosmith stuff, the old AC/DC stuff.
And then it
stuff.
Became a lot of, more drugs, too. Right. Yeah,
yeah, so everyone's got their niche, getting, and yeah. they're a little hooked to keep it going on right there. Mm-hmm.
I like mm-hmm. how you said niche.
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 Do you what's know when it? You said niche, you know what it was?
What's it?
Sexy.
Ooh.
You know what?
Oh, wow.
Ooh.
California was ranked here. One of the sexiest accents in America.
California?
Yep.
Holy shit. No.
I don't know the
Wait a minute.
I don't know that. I don't know
Wait
that
Wait a minute. Which one would that be though? Because there's a lot of lazy speak in California, and that is not sexy at all.
So it says Big not. Seven
to you because you live here. If someone from back east comes by and listens to our California
oh, you mean
speak,
like
they're
the
going to be like
Kardashians where everything ends in a question mark.
See, you oh, we okay. live here, so we don't know the accent. But if we go, we go other places. Right.
Everybody
then we hear
used to do like the Valley Girl, and
yeah, that was its own zip code.
But, yeah, no
so
kidding.
So what is the California accent now? That's
well, it says
what
it says. What do you consider the sexiest accent in the United States? Big Seven Travel surveyed 1.5 million social followers. So that's a lot.
That's a lot.
And ranked them from the most attractive to least. Coming in number one, that Texas drawl described a Southern accent with a twist.
Huh.
Bostonian and New York accents came in 2 and 3, with California accent coming in 10th.
Wow.
It's pretty good.
Here's your California accent right here.
Glad you came over to that one.
Well, I do.
Maybe you should get going before Stuart gets home.
Right. I was thinking I'd take Canyonview Drive over to San Vicente, and then make a left and go 405 north.
Dude.
From there, just get off of Mulholland.
Totally like that.
I love that bit on SNL, the Californians.
It says, California accent is described as a general American accent, but with long vowel sounds.
Okay.
Coming in at the least attractive accent is the Long Islander.
Which is also New York, but it's that's
but a
funny.
Different side of it. So
yeah,
here's the complete,
not that much different.
Here's the complete list.
Do they have samples?
I think
the least attractive is Boston, really.
Let's see. First is Texan, 2 Boston, 3 New York, 4th Maine, 5th Chicago, 6th Mississippi, 7th Hawaiian, 8th Philadelphia, 9th St. Louis, and 10th California.
Hmm.
Huh.
12th is Chicano.
Oh, Donna.
Yeah, right.
Oh, Donna.
The dialect of many
so
Mexican
so
Americans from Texas to California,
no,
Chicano
sexy.
Is much more than just a Spanish accent.
Well, yeah.
Miami, a Youper. Youpernese is a dialect you'll hear in the Upper Peninsula of Michigan.
Youper?
Uh-huh. Is heavily influenced by the area's Scandinavian immigrants, so they say ya instead of yeah, or D for the TH. Dear... For their dat for dat. So get it. Come over to here.
Oh, I wish they had the samples there.
I know.
That's awesome. I'm going to look up Youper and see if I can pull that up. Youper accent.
Yeah. Tennessee and Kansas, Cleveland, New Orleans, New Mexican, better than Old Mexican.
Hell is a San Francisco accent?
Did we just pass it?
Yeah.
Yes. You might not hear it so often with the multiracial mix of folk now living in San Francisco, but the classic San Francisco accent is super fast with words running together. Like, where'd you go?
See, this here says Youper.
Okay.
Hmm.
Oh, that's not my dial.
And the rest of us, and they worship the Patriots. People in Antarctica. Big polar bear and penguin people, I hear. Every place has its key features, which makes it stand out. And most people from those areas show signs that is where they're from. So today I'm giving you 10 signs that you're from the UP of Michigan. Sign number one that you're from the UP of Michigan. You could go to the coldest place in the country where everyone's bundled up in onesies and rocking the latest insulated jeans. And you're gonna be walking up like this with a Cabela's cutoff, jean shorts, tube socks, and flip-flops. Everyone else is sipping coffee and wondering when they'll regain feeling in their toes. You're gonna be shotgunning a Budweiser, wondering how the Packers are gonna do this weekend against the Bears. Sign number two that you're from the UP of Michigan. Everyone thinks you're f***ing Canadian. Well, we're not, eh? Sign number three is you could ask questions like this when you move away to a different college. So do you have plumbing up there? What about running water? Electricity? Do you have to shit outside? What do you think, Franklin and Edison, they just skipped the whole UP? This light bulb's great. Let's not tell those talking to Canadians about it. Sign them.
That's funny, okay, actually.
There's that one there.
It's actually funny. So there you go. The worst on the list is number 50, Long Islander. It says people from...
They say it Long Island. Long Island.
Oh, that's what they did. They spelled it L-A-W-N-G-U-Y-L-A-N, Long Island. Might be a bit upset with voting as having the America's least sexy accent, but look, can they really disagree?
But it's still, it's almost the same as New York.
Well, Jersey is 49th.
And they're all similar.
But if you, but not too much like it, because if you go over there, you go to the top, New York's third.
Yeah, but it's not that different from Long Island.
We're gonna do a Long Island accent here.
The last time I made a vlog, I was in high school. I had not
shut up.
And even though it's small, it's still there, guys. Without further ado, here are the things I say that really only Long Islanders say, or a small minority of the United States population. Number one, the first thing that all Long Islanders do is they say they live on Long Island, and they also wait online. I guess we just really like that aw sound, so we try to use it as often as possible, and I don't know, there's something very weird and wrong about saying living my Long Island culture.
No. Jeez, you suck.
So that was one I had a question on.
Yeah.
If you're going to go wait somewhere in the line, in a long, you can't say it without doing it. Are you wait in line or online?
When you hit the internet.
You go online.
When I'm online, right. I'm online.
But what if you're waiting, say you're waiting at a.
In supermarket. You're
waiting at McDonald's. You're waiting at Albertsons, and there's a long thing of people, and you're last. Are you waiting in line or online?
I'm in line.
Okay.
That's when I'm in line.
How do you say it?
In line.
Okay.
Yeah.
I hear people say online.
Yeah. I'm online at the store.
And that's what he said that made me think of that.
Gotcha.
I'm online. What do you mean you're online? You're not. What do you mean you're online? I'm online. No, you're not online.
I get that. Yeah.
I sounded like who Cooper tells me I am.
Well, my mom was from Long Island. My mom was from Long Island, but she spent a lot of time also in Manhattan. So it just kind of all blended together. But one of her key things that she used to say was, "You want a cup of coffee?"
Yeah, my dad does that. My dad has
and that's just a typical New York.
My dad has the often. He hits that hard chi on that. So look at that. It's already 8:32. We are wrapping this baby up. 8:32 in the morning. What are we, Roy?
Roy and Jimmy in the morning.
Where are we located, Donna?
We are on Live 365.
Look at that.
On YouTube. And we're global now.
There you go. 909.
509.
4-0-6-3.
We're coming back. Big finish.
Why do I go like this? It's not there.
There's a whole lot of air drumming going on here.
That was a big finish right there. It's Roy and Jimmy in the morning with Donna Main right here on J Radio. We're wrapping up. It's 8:45 on your Tuesday morning. We're almost out of here, and you all should be at work by now. You little vixens, you. You little back-to-work days. Like I said, it is a bummer after 3 days, but guess what? You've only got 3 more days to go.
Yeah.
The blessings of a short week.
There you go.
The blessings of your short week right there.
The blessings we all have. Let's be thankful.
So how do you say that word?
I don't know. I try to pull it up. We're reading a script, a radio, an advertising script of something we're going to do. But
I think I have it here.
Go ahead, do it.
Let's see. Let's make sure there's not an ad.
Do it.
Citus.
Oh, Latin. Citus.
Oh, so citus.
Citust.
Citus, Latin.
Citus. And they put an ED on it. So
citus,
it,
Latin.
So it's Cytist Latin.
I'm guessing.
That's weird.
That's a weird name. Why wouldn't you say?
What? But I mean, people don't commonly use that, so.
It's probably why they use it.
But.
Cytus.
Ooh.
Cytus.
Okay, that's easier Cytus. To say that
so
way, too.
So for advertising purposes, though, wouldn't that be confusing?
Well, that's why. Because it's the legal disclaimer. Legal jargon. At the bottom. So that's all part of the disclaimer.
Yeah.
Mm.
So I'm wondering if that's just what they use in that. You know, like you do
to
it.
Be fancy.
Well, you do it. You see it in medical mm-hmm. where certain language is used in different.
Everything's Latin.
Yeah.
Everything's a little different. Yeah. Descriptions. Yeah. Yeah. I mean, you don't look over and go, get that fucker over here. Yeah. No.
Well, I do.
I love the stories my mom used to tell.
This guy was selling him on the off-ramp over by the two.
The two?
Devin? What are you doing here?
That's California right there.
That is. Well, see, everything. Yeah, it's where everything ends in a question.
I love that part.
But it's even lazier now, like with the Kardashian speak and everything. It's so lazy. They sound like it takes so much effort just to get out a whole sentence.
Hanging us on there.
Yeah.
What do we got going, Roy? We had a holiday weekend just ending right there, Roy.
We got a new number one.
Want to do a top 10, top 5? What do you want to do?
Top 10 quick. Number 10, long shot, fourth week. 1.64 million. They're at 28 million over a four-week run. Number 9, The Intruder, fourth week out also. 2.3 million this week for a total of 31,965.
What is The Intruder? I saw a long
someone comes
shot.
In. Someone comes into your building and they break
really?
In.
And they clean and they clean
they
up.
They clean the house?
Thanks for explaining that. Is that what that one is?
They clean your house and carpets and all that shit?
Yeah, exactly.
I don't know what it's about, Jimmy.
I'm on it, baby.
That's it. We'll go number 8 while he's looking it up. Number 8, The Hustle in their third week out, $3.8 million this week for a total of $29.837 million.
Scott didn't get such great ratings. So.
Scott and Ann Russell couldn't be happier about buying their dream home from a mysterious and lonely widower named Charlie in Napa Valley. We've talked about this before.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
Number 4 in their second week out, $4.15 million, A Dog's Journey. Two-week run, $14 million.
Number 4?
Yep.
Oh, no,
number
this 7. Week it's number 7.
Number 7. In their fourth week. Third week. Fourth, second week. Whatever. Number 6, Booksmart in their first week out. It is their debut at $6.92 million. No idea. Number 5,
I saw it.
We're just going to blow through the shit.
Number 5, first week out. Again, debut weekend, $7.865 million. Number 4.
Did you say what it was called?
Yeah. Brightburn. I didn't say it. Now that I said it, I know I didn't
you
say
didn't
it.
You didn't say Brightburn.
Number 4, Pokemon Detective Pikachu, third week out, $13.3 million for a three-week run of $116 million.
Pikachu.
Son of a bitch. God bless you. Number 3, Avengers Endgame, fifth week out, still $17 million for a five-week run of $798 million.
What was that old line that says I'd pay a lot of money to get a Pikachu?
Yeah.
If you have kids.
The Pikachu.
Pika.
It reminds me of Johnny Carson when he looked over at Dolly. Remember when he told Dolly Parton?
Oh, I give you your salary. Your
salary,
pick of
those.
Pika under there.
Yeah. There's a Dolly clip that I want to find where people ask you about stupid things and how she answers them. It's like, are those things fake?
Oh, gotcha. Okay.
No, are those things real? And she looks at him in her Dolly way. She's just answering these things. She goes, real expensive. You know, it's funny.
Yeah,
she's so cute.
I love her. Yeah. So John Wick, Chapter 3, sitting at number 2 in their second week out, $24.6 million, a two-week run of $101 million. And the new number 1, I still think Derek Murray should have been playing this part, Aladdin 2019 at $90.4 million in their first week out.
He was born. For this role,
I wish we know what it was when it was filming because we could have done it.
He stunt double. We could have just pushed him right on the side because he did post that picture again from his youth a few days ago, and this, I think he fits the bill much more.
Oh yeah,
than the hack artist they picked for that right there.
What time is it?
We have 10 minutes.
We'll save this for another one. We'll save all these stories for next one. Donna.
Oh, okay.
What do you got?
Oh,
I thought you said for a story, would you?
No, because it's we had 10 till. We'll let her do it.
Oh, gotcha.
Well,
just a little bit of a Hunk Report, guys. Speaking of movies, I did see two of the movies on that list. Can you believe that?
No, I cannot.
I saw Long Shot and I saw Booksmart.
Yes.
And they're both comedies. Pretty good. Booksmart is all high school stuff. But this is the thing. Every movie these days has to get like really more sexual stuff that, I don't know. The one thing I didn't like about Long Shot, if you know what Long Shot, the story is.
Not at all.
Okay.
I remember we talked about it, but I don't remember.
Okay. Long Shot is Charlize Theron.
Oh, with Seth Rogen.
And Seth Rogen.
Yeah.
And it's the long shot is that would he be able to end up with a girl like her? She's Secretary of State, and then she ends up running for president and da-da-da-da-da.
Mm-hmm.
And he's like the goofy guy, but he's a journalist. And anyway, long story short, the thing I don't understand, and this is going to make me sound really old, when did it become, especially in this day and age of Me Too, when did it become normal for every woman to want to be slapped and choked during sex?
That's the majority of them.
That's been a long time.
Yeah. Yeah, choke me.
But why? I don't know. I don't find it romantic. I'm just saying. Me Too, isn't that an assault? I don't know.
Well, not if you're asking for it.
Yeah, but
you get off on it.
You're not. I'm not forcing you to choke you out.
But it's. I don't know.
If you're like, get over here, do me, daddy, and choke me.
It's always okay.
It's a fetish.
But you know what? It's that asphyxiation thing.
They're normalizing it, is what I'm saying. It's like everybody's, you know, it's like the thing they do now is like everybody's got to be into it.
I mean, in the 70s, everyone had a big old hairy bush, and now they don't anymore. So everything's into it.
And it's like that little foot fetish thing we covered a few weeks ago. Everyone's got their kinks, and you get off on a little slap.
It's supposed to heighten
the orgasm, the asphyxiation part of it. And a lot of people go for it, and they're like, "Hey, they're absolutely right, but it's not my cup of tea, man."
Well, people were dying from it because they were choking themselves out.
People die from it. Yeah.
Oh,
I don't know. I'm
coming and I'm gone. A few people ventured into that. Yeah.
What I'm wondering is, I mean, if you choking out does that to you, mm-hmm. I mean, when that guy went out.
He went out with a bang.
Because if he was hanging there upside down while he was having a good time.
Quick, grab my belt. Right. It's time.
Anyway.
That's too much prep,
well,
man.
Well, anyway. No, so, I thought Long Shot, it had its moments. It got pretty good reviews, but I didn't think it was all that.
It just looks like a stupid fun movie with Seth Rogen.
But yeah, it's always pushing the shit about let's get, you know, that sex has to be a little kinkier and a little, you know.
Fuck.
And yeah.
Hell yeah, yo.
And then where's a moment of climax is the take him to the ultimate. There.
Now that's sexy. That's sexy
now
right
that's
there.
That's sexy right there.
Sheet in my pants.
So one of the movies that I'm really looking forward to that's coming out in July is Once Upon a Time in Hollywood.
I want to see that one.
Quentin Tarantino's ninth film, and as you probably know, I love the look of it because it's 1969. It's so nostalgic. It's all this cool Hollywood.
The look
stuff.
Is 69. Where it just peaked.
Yeah, I saw that.
What year?
Yeah.
Well, you know what I do.
What
like
year, Donna?
1969.
I'm about ready to choke myself.
Oh god. What I like about it, it also it being a period piece that he actually did it in actual. He actually did the dressing up of Sunset Strip in the old school instead of CGIing and all that.
I love this nostalgic type stuff. It's really cool.
I saw one of the previews. Now, I saw one of the previews for that, and my dad's station wagon's in it. The old 65 New Yorker.
Yeah.
It's awesome.
I mean, I want to see it for that alone.
It just looks
so cool. And of course, it's got a stellar cast. You know, Leonardo DiCaprio is this actor who's afraid that he's kind of washed up, and his stunt double is Brad Pitt.
Right.
And I don't know exactly the whole story, but it does parallel with some real real shit because it's the time of the Sharon Tate, the Manson murders, mm-hmm. and all that stuff. So it looks incredibly interesting. It's getting standing ovations. One of the weird things I read, because they have Bruce Lee in this film.
Mm-hmm.
Bruce Lee is all over this movie. It says played by Mike Mo, because they're doing like the Kung Fu movies and all that stuff. And one of the interesting things it says that at one time, Bruce Lee was a suspect, and in the death of Sharon Tate.
Yeah, probably by association.
This was the thing. It all this weird stuff ties together. I always find these stories really interesting. Jay Sebring, who was one of the people that was killed at Sharon Tate's house, was the inspiration for the Warren Beatty film Shampoo, because he was the hairstylist guy.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so I mean, it's just a lot of interesting things that all tie together. But I guess Roman Polanski thought he knew Bruce Lee quite well, and at one point he thought that maybe Bruce Lee was the killer, because the killer or killers left a pair of glasses at the house. And one morning after the murders, Lee casually mentioned to Polanski, "I've lost my glasses." So at one point, there's a whole big thing in here. So at one point,
he's like the 60s version of OJ. I'm going to find the real killers.
Well, yeah, because, Polanski was weird in his own right. But apparently, and he was older than Sharon Tate. They were married. She was pregnant at the time.
We're going to find that son of a bitch.
So I think at one point, you know, Roman Polanski was thinking maybe Bruce Lee was secretly in love with her or some kind of weird shit. And then maybe he had actually, because his body was a lethal weapon. He knew how to use all kinds of
things. Like Roman was the killer, trying to point it on everybody else.
At one point, he was one of the people that he suspected. But anyway.
There was a cigarette butt right there, and I noticed Bruce Lee smoked too. Dun, dun.
Well, I'm sure there was a lot of, you know, wild and crazy parties going on, and who knows what. But anyway,
people were sprinkling DNA everywhere.
Yeah,
damn, Sean.
That's right.
Is this your cigarette butt?
We go back to the sprinkling of the DNA.
Yeah. You sprinkle that DNA all over the place. You sons of bitches! Look at that! We're already buzzing down on this thing. Holy shit!
I love how times change in talking about smoking. When you're looking at old baseball movies or mm-hmm. like clips and stuff, and you see the dude smoking in the dugout.
I think one of my favorite ones, it was a football player, and I forgot his name, but he just Hall of Fame in between quarters, he's on the bench sweating and he's got a cigarette going on. Let's go, woo, that's a tough game right here.
I remember going Dodger games as a kid and watching Steve Yeager smoke in the outfield.
Oh, that's right. Yeah. Yeah. Blowing a smoke at waiting for that ball. It's coming. All right,
I can never understand
Let me put that down.
I can never understand how athletes and singers can smoke a lot, you know?
Well, they didn't know then. Now they take better care of themselves. Well, athletes absolutely do.
But a lot of people that sing still smoke. Right. And it's like, all I have to do is inhale smoke and I lose my voice. So I don't know how to do that.
These people are smoking and getting choked.
Yeah. Yeah, I know.
They're living the life right now. Yeah. I got to smoke. Yeah, you want to choke me? That'll work for me.
Yeah.
Yahoo.
All right, guys, look at that. We are wrapped up here. It is.
Oh, that was the other thing, too, about the Tarantino movie. He was supposed to make that with the Harvey Weinstein company.
Oh, well,
and then when all of that stuff happened, he shopped it around, and everybody was bidding for this to do this movie.
Oh, good. Turned out a better thing.
So I think it's Sony that actually made the film.
Very nice. Very nice. Look at that. It has been Roy and Jim in the Morning with Donna Main. Thank you guys for listening yesterday and today. We'll be back on Monday morning, 7 to 9, right here, RJ Radio.
All right, guys.
And we have interesting, nice little blocks of music going on RJ Radio 24/7. Definitely tune in and relax. Get some background music. Let RJ Radio take you through all your days. And let us take you Monday, Tuesday mornings. That's it. Have a great week.
Guys, I'll have a great week. Remember, next Monday morning, we'll be speaking to actress model Canyon Fessler.
All right. Have a great week, everybody. We'll be back on Monday.
All right. Love you all. Hit them, baby.
Bye.